morning children, hearty welcome to our online class, subject science, class 8. Today we are going to see a new topic, that is the unit name is air. Air is a mixture of gases that surrounds our planet Earth. It is essential for the survival of all the living things. We know that we need air and we are depending upon the air for our survival. And then air contains 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and then 0.93% of argon, 0.04% of carbon dioxide, and small amount of other gas also. Generally, we do breathe in oxygen and we do breathe out carbon dioxide. Plants, in turn, use carbon dioxide for the process of photosynthesis and they release oxygen into the atmosphere. Since men have been cutting down trees for their needs, the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is increasing. This is responsible for the rising of atmospheric temperature. So in this lesson, we are going to study about the effects like greenhouse effect, global warming and acid rain. And we will also study about the occurrence and properties of the gases like oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. Now let us see oxygen. All living things in the world need oxygen. We cannot imagine the world without oxygen. Is it possible to live without oxygen? No, we can't able to live. So we are directly depending upon the oxygen for our survival. And a scientist called Scheele, he only first discovered oxygen during the year 1772. He called the gas as fire air or vital life because it was found to support the process of burning. So generally we know that for burning process we need oxygen gas. Without oxygen it can't able to burn or it can't able to combustion. It was independently discovered by the British scientist Joseph Priestley in 1774. Lavoisier only named oxygen, and the name oxygen comes from the Greek word which means oxygenes, and the meaning is acid producer. It is called so because early chemists thought that oxygen is necessary for all acids. And now occurrence of oxygen. Atmospheric air, in the atmospheric air it contains 21% and it is in the free state, while in case of water it is about 88 to 90%. In case of occurrence of oxygen during the free state or without any combined without combination process, in case of atmospheric air oxygen is in 21%, while in case of water it is 88 to 90%. And then in the combined state, in case of plants and animals, the percentage is around 60 to 70%, while in case of minerals in the form of silicate, carbonate and in oxide, the percentage level is 45 to 50%. And we all know that for the photosynthesis process with the help of photosynthesis only we are getting the oxygen gas only. So CO2, that is carbon dioxide, which is present in the trees, it do combines with the water, and in presence of the energy obtained from sun it do forms the food. So generally plants, they do produce food by means of combining carbon dioxide with water. In presence of energy from the sun, they do form their food, that is carbohydrates. And during that process only, they do release out oxygen gas. And now we shall see the physical properties of oxygen. And can we able to see the oxygen gas in the air? No, it is not possible. So it is a colorless gas and it is an odorless gas also, or it is a tasteless gas also. It is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. and generally oxygen dissolves readily in cold water, and it is highly denser than air, and it supports combustion process also. Now let us see the chemical properties of oxygen. So we do have five different chemical properties of oxygen. The first one is combustion or combustibility, and the second property is reaction with the metal, and third one is reaction with the non-metal, and the fourth property is reaction with the hydrocarbon, and the last one is rusting. So we do have five different chemical properties of oxygen. Now let us see the first property, that is combustibility. Oxygen is a non-combustible gas as it does not burn on its own, and it supports for the combustion of other substances also. And the second property is reaction with the metal. Generally, oxygen reacts with the metals like sodium, potassium, magnesium, aluminium to form their corresponding metal oxide, which are generally basic in nature. So if you see, in case of any metal, they do combine with the oxygen to form metallic oxide. For example, if you see sodium, it combines with the oxygen to form sodium oxide. Similarly, it do forms various oxides also when they do combine with the different types of metals. In case of potassium, it forms potassium oxide. In case of magnesium, it forms magnesium oxide. For calcium, it do form calcium oxide. In case of iron, it forms iron oxide. While in case of gold or in platinum, it does not involve any reaction. They won't react with the metals like gold or silver or platinum. Sorry, in case of silver, it do form silver oxide. And the third property, reaction with the non-metal. Oxygen, they do react with various non-metals like hydrogen, nitrogen, carbon, sulfur to give out their corresponding non-metallic oxides, which are generally acidic in nature. Therefore, non-metal combines with the oxygen to form non-metallic oxide. For example, if you see, in case of carbon, it reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Similarly, in case of nitrogen, it forms nitric oxide. In case of sulfur, it forms sulfur dioxide. While in case of phosphorus, it forms phosphorus trioxide or phosphorus pentoxide. And now let us see the fourth chemical property, that is reaction with the hydrocarbon. Do you know what is meant by hydrocarbon? Yes, they do have hydrogen and carbon in their structure. They do have the compounds or elements like hydrogen and carbon. So hydrocarbon reacts with the oxygen to form carbon dioxide and then water vapor also. For example, wood, petrol, diesel, when they burn in oxygen, they produce heat and light energy. So any hydrocarbon reacts with the oxygen to form carbon dioxide with the water vapor, and they do emit heat energy and light energy also. And now let us see the fifth property, that is rusting. Do you know in which type of metal generally rusting will be occurring? Yes, in case of iron only, the process of rusting will be taken place. So generally, iron will combine with the oxygen to form iron oxide. They do involve during that process, they do forms the rusting, or it do forms rust. It is a hydrated form of ferric oxide only. And now let us see the uses of oxygen. So it is used as oxyacetylene light for cutting and welding metals. It is used to remove carbon impurities from steel. And then plants and animals use oxygen from the air for respiration, used to oxidize rocket fuel, used for the artificial respiration by scuba divers and then by mountaineers and astronauts. It is used in the synthesis of methanol and ammonia also. These are all the important uses of oxygen. And then now let us see the today's home fun. Your first question, give any two physical properties of oxygen. Second question, what will happen when oxygen combines with metal? Third question, write the reaction between hydrocarbon and oxygen. And your last question, list any four uses of oxygen. Thank you, children.